Frosty were the trees that passed furiously in my train window, with their branches resembling cancerous veins, frozen rigid in the cast iron grey sky. Passing buildings looked like concrete cakes, towered upon one another, ostensible to tiers of a futile wedding cake. Crowded, sullen and dismal offices merged into an elevation that kisses the nadir of heaven, stretches far across the white horizon. The train carriage rattled with a vacuous metallic roaring, and background echo aria. That was briefly interrupted by the passing call, Stetchford. Stetchford, our next stop.
So we're talking about your novel, Nothing is Concrete. Could you tell us a little about what you're trying to explain with the title?
I remember the title coming out of weirdly, just the thought that I had one. I was going through such a rocky patch, and I just remember saying to myself, nothing is this concrete. Mm-hmm. And then I was thinking, well, what is nothing then? There's nothing that I'm feeling, or the world, or maybe this apathy or this bereft feeling within me can change, or is it stuck? So I thought, well, I might as well have that as the title of my novel at the end of the day, just to convey that meaning.
So does your novel have any specific message?
I would say two clear-cut ones. One definitely being, the universe is so harsh, and the world is quite brutal, and I don't think it's worth the effort, almost, unless you have someone or something to love. It's not, it cannot be overcome. The second one is learning to understand the universe, because once you understand it, you can be a part of it, and once you're a part of it, you can forgive it for what it's done to you.
It seems as though it's been non-stop raining in recent times, and rust has set in everywhere around me. Clouds are furious and are pissing hailstones onto my head. The puddles on the pavements are full with my spilled blood. And here I am in my prison, staring at a tree which perpetually sheds its leaves. Is this the world I was so desperate to be a part of with her? Maybe it would have been different if she was here and loved me like I loved her. I could feel her fingertips touching mine as I led her to the world, which I couldn't face alone. And just like Orpheus, I turned to look at her and she disappeared. I was happy when I was with her and could die, but now I'm bereft and have to die. Meeting in that fateful crossing of my downfall, and then I was sucked, drawn and pulled and dragged into a vortex of tumultuous angst. Utterly saturated with misery, I have decided to write about her. That's all I can do with these emotions that I have for her. Wrap some flesh on these spectre-like and ghoulish thoughts of passion. I love her. I curl into the machine that will be pounded by my fingertips. The sun is coming up, or maybe there's an inferno raging somewhere on the horizon. I cannot tell anymore. My eyes are tattered with toil.
Part 1 has the subtitle Outer Restriction, and Part 2 has the subtitle Inner Restriction. What do you mean by this?
I guess it's following on from, the messages. Outer Restriction, I explore mainly the social constraints upon the individual, and the cultural restraints as well. I'm restrained. How can I move? Where's my freedom? I'm clutching for freedom. The more you feel restrained, the more frenetic, and also you hit pangs of panic. That's the problem, and that's when the nothing can take over.
You say you have existentialist thought that has influenced you in your writing significantly.
Highly influenced by the Heideggerian idea of subject-object in the world, and maybe reanalyzing it the wrong way. And I do try and explain that through my novel, through coping with the scenarios that can almost make the subject and the object more apparent. Second, the inner restriction is the only way I could have ever broken it, because me as a subject wouldn't be able to affect the outer unless I change my inner. So, the inner restriction, rather. One of the major aspects of my novel being the woman who brought me from the nothing. She just pulled me away from it and brought life screaming and hitting me back into living. And finally, I was aware and I could forgive.
The world is dark with its beauty hidden. The day's chaos is veiled. And the only thing I can feel is what I have for her. I need light. Where is the beacon? Where is the tower? Where is the woman who's taken my heart? With light, there is fuel to ride in the nocturnal wilderness and write, write, and write. I never needed her. But I needed to have her there. I walked into my life on my own, and I vanished out of it alone. Leaving my heart soiled as if covered with crusty eczema. She was my cure, but my love was her disease. The love that I held for her is now shattered, as she ran from my hands like slipping grains of sand.
So if you could describe Nothing as Concrete in the most simple of terms, how would you go about it?
I reckon the simplest way is just a man who jumps on a train between Coventry and Birmingham, Birmingham back to Coventry, and just the world happening inside of him. Yeah, nothing really wanky in that.
I figured that.
Yeah, all right.
No, don't do the eyes. You just look a bit crazy.
Just the camera's on. Okay, the train.
What the fuck?